No camera available captures every image perfectly, but some get pretty darn close. Issues that can arise when filming that affects how your image can come out can be caused by a variety of different elements. One of the built-in features that can cause users problems with the Pocket 4K is the rolling shutter. I wanted to take a look at the rolling shutter on the Pocket 4K and give you some quick information on the different aspects and issues involved with the shutter in 360 seconds. As always, make sure to subscribe below and hit the notification bell to stay up to date with all of our content. Before I really get into some of the issues revolving around the rolling shutter on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera, let's dig into what a rolling shutter actually is for the uninitiated among us or those of you who just need the refresher. The term rolling shutter refers to the type of image captured on your camera. On a video camera, each frame of the video is not captured by getting a snapshot of the scene all at once. Instead, the image capturing will rapidly scan the whole scene, which can be done vertically or horizontally. As I'm sure you've guessed, this can cause some significant distortions, whether it be rapid flashes of lights or objects moving quickly. Of course, the contrast of the rolling shutter is what is known as the global shutter. The main difference between these two is that the global shutter will capture the whole frame at the same time as opposed to scanning the frame. While you definitely can find either of these shutter types on a variety of cameras using CMOS sensors, the lion's share of those available on the market use the rolling shutter. But we're not talking about those other devices, so let's move on and take a peek at the rolling shutter on the BMPCC4K. There are a few known issues that come with the rolling shutter, but your personal results may vary depending on your setup and how you use your camera. Unfortunately, we can't get into every issue that is caused by the shutter, so let's just run through a couple of them. First off, there's some artifacting reported to happen while using the shutter. Artifacting is when unwanted changes to the subject you're capturing will appear in the image or video product. A couple of really good examples of artifacting is chromatic aberration and noise in the image. Keep in mind though that artifacting is not something that only happens with a rolling shutter. It's pretty common and can pop up with any sort of digital photography or videography. One of the effects that users can also experience is something known as wobble, which is known as the jello effect. Wobble incidents can happen when shooting from a moving object such as a car, but can also occur during handheld shots. Pretty much in any scenario where the camera itself is moving, if it's not like on a gimbal or something that can kind of keep it stabilized. When an image bends diagonally in one direction, while the subject moves from side to side of the frame is known as skew, and it's also another issue that users experience when using rolling shutter. To explain this, let's think of the motion of helicopter blades. While filming this action with rolling shutter, the blades of the helicopter can almost look unnaturally bent. This is because as the helicopter is being captured, different parts are exposed at different times. The varying frame rates involved with rolling shutter can cause another effect called temporal aliasing, known less affectionately as the wagon wheel effect. Going forward with the example of a spoked wheel, you can picture a motorcycle wheel if westerns and wagons aren't your thing, aliasing can change the observed motion of the wheel, making it look like it's moving backwards or slower than it's rotating in real life. So what are some ways to combat the rolling shutter issues that can come up with the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera? Really, the best way to avoid some of the rolling shutter effects is to find ways to keep your camera stationary while shooting. This can be accomplished by avoiding handheld shooting altogether, if possible. One of the most obvious ways to accomplish this is with a tripod, but this depends on what your project is and that may not be the most practical method. Many users find that Steadicam support is an excellent way to combat these issues as well. Now, if the idea of spending hundreds or thousands of extra dollars on more equipment makes your stomach turn a little bit, there is the option of fixing the effects caused by the rolling shutter during the editing process. Fix it in post is obviously the cliche phrase, but an effective method. It seems that the best way to go about this is with the use of Adobe Premiere Pro. This program specifically has rolling shutter repair built into it and is pretty idiot-proof, assuming you are already familiar with video editing software in general. Now for some final thoughts on the rolling shutter and how it affects the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera. Is it an obstacle to overcome when using this camera? Absolutely. But you manage your way around these issues by understanding what causes it and how to correct it. This does make handheld shooting a little bit more difficult, but if you can minimize it a little bit by doing things like weighting your rigs properly or using a shoulder-mounted rig or even attaching a gimbal, it can kind of fix some of the issues for you and you can still get a handheld look if you'd like. You just have to plan a little bit ahead for it. And as always, plan to experiment with it and see what it can handle in your specific area of work. Feel like I missed something or said something wrong? Please let me know in the comments below so we can correct it. Thanks for watching today's episode. Be sure to subscribe to our channel below and hit the notification bell to keep up to date with all of our videos. Until next time, this is John Owens with Frame Voyager.